Well, this is Dr. Mark Hitchcock. I want to thank all of you for joining us for another episode of Marking the Times. And certainly these are some interesting times to mark. There's been so much happening here in the last few months. We've had this terrible pandemic of coronavirus. And now that's been followed up by a lot of just social unrest in our country. It's, again, I know I've said this several times, but we've used the word unprecedented and uncertain and these words over and over again. But these are perilous times in which we live today. And I want to just talk about what we've been seeing kind of on television the last week or two, and just try to put it in a little bit of perspective for us. You know, we've all heard, I'm sure, a lot of the social perspective on this, and the political perspective, and maybe the economic perspective on what's happening. But I want to try to bring a prophetic perspective to it. But before that, I want to just bring a personal perspective that I hope will be of some help to us and some encouragement to all of us. And just as from a personal perspective, I just want to make a statement that I hope should be obvious to all of us, but that is that racism is wrong. Racism is sinful. It has no place in the life of a Christian. We all are image bearers, bearing the image of our Creator, of God. And I think for every person of decency, even if you're not a Christian, I think, you know, watching what happened to Mr. Floyd and Mr. Arbery, it's sad. It's tragic, it's wrong, and it's very difficult to watch. So I think that's something that every one of us as Christians should recognize, and we should be praying for those families and be praying for these communities that are being affected. So just from a personal perspective, I want to bring that to bear on this issue. But there's also a prophetic perspective to this, and I think, you know, having said what I've said, I think we would be naive not to understand and to see clearly that selfish opportunists have come in and seized the legitimate grief and anger that's out there to serve their own evil agendas. They're stirring up strife. They're rebelling against lawful authority. They're destroying property. They're stealing. There's killing. There's just fomenting of anarchy. Now, certainly, there's a lot of legitimate protest that's going on. That's part of the history of our country. Protest is a good thing. It's something that we're afforded by our Constitution. It's a wonderful right that we have. But again, this has been seized by opportunists. And we really said the same thing about coronavirus. With coronavirus, it's kind of like I mentioned how Rahm Emanuel, the former chief of staff of President Obama, said, you know, never let a good crisis go to waste. And the coronavirus was seized upon by globalists and others. And in the same way, these terrible, tragic events have been seized upon in some cases by those who are using these for their own evil ends. And as I thought about what's happening, a couple passages came to mind. Matthew 24, verse 12 in the Olivet Discourse. Jesus' disciples ask him, what are going to be the sign of your coming in the end of the age? And Jesus in that verse says, because lawlessness is increased, most people's love will grow cold. Lawlessness is going to be increased and people's love is going to grow cold. And we see that a lot in our culture today, just a lack of love and a lack of decency in people's relationships with one another. And now, by the way, I'm going to begin not this coming Sunday, but the next week on June 14th here at the church, a series in 1 Corinthians 13 about love. And I think that's something that's desperately needed in our culture today and in all of our lives. Another passage that came to mind is 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1. But realize this, in the last days, difficult times will come. Now, a couple things about this verse. When it says in the last days, now most people read that and they think of the last days as just being kind of the end times or the last days before the coming of Jesus. A lot of you, I'm sure, know this, but the last days is the entire period between the first and second comings of Jesus. So we've been in the last days now for 2,000 years. And the Apostle Paul is saying, in the last days, in this long period of time between the first and second coming of Jesus, difficult times will come. So what he's saying is during this entire period, it's going to be punctuated by times that are especially difficult, or the King James translates it there, perilous. And I think as we look at our world right now in our country, we'd say we're in one of those perilous times. And actually that word in the Greek is the word kalapoi, which is the same word used in Matthew 8:28 of the demoniacs that Jesus met. And it's a word that literally means vicious or brutal or savage. And so it's saying here, in this period known as the last days, it's going to be punctuated by perilous, brutal, violent times. And I think we're clearly in one of those now. And again, he goes on to say, men will be lovers of self. And you know, one thing I can't get over is you see these riots and this unrest is how many people are carrying their phones around, you know, looking in there, taking selfies and filming things. And it's just kind of a narcissistic picture of people just wanting to be part of something like this and a focus on self while all this violence and chaos is going on. Going down, it mentions revilers. It mentions without self-control, brutal, haters of good, treacherous, reckless. On and on we can go. But we're in, I think, one of these perilous, savage, kind of brutal times that will characterize the last days. And so as we see these things happening, again, it's part of the matrix of events and the convergence of events that we see all around us. I mean, you know, right on the heels of coronavirus comes this this other pandemic, if you will, a pandemic of violence that we're facing. You say, well, what do we do in times like this? Well, we want to be praying for those who are affected. We want to be praying for our nation, our leaders. Let me read in 1 Timothy 2, where Paul wrote this. First of all, then I urge that entreaties and prayers, petitions and thanksgivings be made on behalf of all men, for kings, for all who are in authority, so that we may lead a tranquil and quiet life in all godliness and dignity. And what he's saying here is we need to pray so that there'll be peace in our society so we can live a tranquil life because that allows the gospel and the preaching of God's word to prosper. So let's commit during this time to be people of prayer who are praying for those who are affected, praying for our leaders, praying for our communities, and asking God to work in our own hearts so that our love won't grow cold, so that we'll be a loving people, loving in our families, loving to people around us in our culture and our churches, and to be found to be loving people and caring people when Jesus comes, because I believe his coming could be very soon in light of all the things we're seeing in our world today. Well, thank you for joining us again. God bless you. We'll hope to see you next time.